All right, switching gears tonight, it is launch night on our Space Coast, and in just a few hours, Crew 8 is set to blast off from the Kennedy Space Center. That's where West 2's Scott Heidler is joining us live tonight. And Scott, how are things looking for tonight's big launch? We're excited.
Well, right now we're still only tracking about a 40% go, and that's due to weather, but launch managers are pushing forward. The countdown clock is ticking just over about 5 hours now until that instantaneous launch window opens at 11:16 later tonight. Crew 8's original launch window just after midnight on Friday scrubbed due to bad weather along the East Coast. That's the track the SpaceX Crew Dragon Endeavour atop a Falcon 9 booster will take once it lifts off from Launch Complex 39A here at the Kennedy Space Center. This is Endeavour's fifth mission to the International Space Station, all part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program, learning from each mission.
The teams comb through the data, both SpaceX and NASA, making sure, hey, did we catch everything? Was anything a little weird? Did everything operate the way we thought they would? And we have been able to build on everything or on that knowledge throughout the now 9 crewed missions that we're getting ready to launch.
It's been absolutely incredible to watch spaceflight explode here at the Cape.
The 4 getting ready to launch in Crew 8 arrived here at the Kennedy Space Center last Sunday. Commander Matthew Dominick, a Navy test pilot on his first space mission, is Crew 8's commander. Veteran astronaut and medical doctor Michael Barrett on his third space mission. NASA's mission specialist Jeanette Epps, before becoming an astronaut, worked at the CIA. And Russian Alexander Grebenkin served in his country's Air Force. The crew will be busy during their 6 months on station. 200 science experiments, from digging into the impact of long-term microgravity on the human body to growing stem cells in space. One thing to note for those of us here on the Space Coast, this Falcon 9 booster will be returning to landing zone 1 here on the Cape, so we'll hear that double clack sonic boom just before it touches down, and it should touch down probably about 7.5 minutes after launch here. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.